Hey folks, AJ the CEO here, and in this video, I want to walk you through using a website called make.com to add some automation to your email. So that way, if somebody sends you an email, you can automatically get a response and just leverage some of these tools. We're going to be adding more and more tools with this feature because this was something I promised a long time ago and finally got a chance to actually do it. So let me just walk you through how this whole thing works. All right, so like I said, we're going to be utilizing a website called make.com, and it will help integrate a bunch of these AI tools together, which I kind of like, and I've been guilty of this as well too. So most of the time I'll have people email me at questions@ajholmes.com. I tell them I have 48 to 72 hours to respond, and I kind of wanted to have a automated response. Now, yes, you can build this into Gmail or Google Workspace or whatever email that you want, but again, this is the foundation of a bunch of things I want to start building out. So I want to just show you an example of how this works. So inside of here, and it's free to set this up, I am going to create a new scenario here. And you can give it a name. And I'm going to use this for an email that I can actually use. So I'll just say check for YouTube messages. So when people can go to my business line, I get emails, and people can go to the about page and email me, but a bunch of scam people asking me to, oh, we love your channel on Media Ministry, and we would love for you to test out our barbecue, like just dumb spam emails to come through. So this is the reason I'm actually going to be using this, to have something be a little bit more intelligent to read through and analyze the stuff that's going on. But we're going to start simple. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to link this to our email. So we'll just click on this humongous plus here, and we're going to search for Gmail. They have tons and tons of more tools that are being added to make here. So I want this. So Gmail is verified with them. You have a bunch of features that you can do under email. You can watch emails, which is what we're going to use, but you can copy an email, create a draft, delete email, mark email as read, modified labels, all this other fun stuff, send an email. But like I said, we're going to start with watch emails. All right. So we need to link it to our account first. So we would have a linkage here. And again, I already have one, but all you would have to do is just do add and sign into your account. That's really all you got to do. But I'm already here. So now what are we going to be looking for in your email? I want it to look in all of my emails, my entire email folder, but then I want it to filter for a specific email. I have multiple emails that can come into my workspace. So I want to do a Gmail filter. And for this filter, I want it to be to, I'm looking for emails that are coming to info@ajholmes.com. That's what I'm looking for. And now you can be way more granular. So if you say you're looking for, like sometimes I'll say, hey, I want to shout out your media ministry team on our Q&As, and send me an email and make the subject my media team. If you tell people to do that, you can say, look for emails with the subject as this. So you can get way more filtered if you want to. But I'm going to do this here, make it real simple. And my scroll bar isn't moving for me. All right, so the next thing we have is, do you want to mark the email as read? No, I don't. I just want this to be an automated email to go back out to people. All right, and then how many results, that we can keep it as that, and then we're just going to save. And where do you want to start from? I want it to start from here on. We don't want it to look at all the emails you've already gotten. We just want this to go forward. So I'm going to go ahead and save that. So that's the first section. The next, we're going to add another module to this. So what it gets in module one will hand off to the next module. So the next module is still going to be Gmail, but we want to send an email based off of that. So what are we going to do? We already have our linkage because we already made that. We want to send an email to the recipient that just mailed us. So it's going to bring up a whole bunch of stuff here, right? So what I'm going to do is, who are we going to send it to? We want to send this to the email address of the person that came from here. So I'm just going to bring this over here. So it's going to grab the email from the first one, and send it right back to that person. And you could add more people in here if you wanted to. Now, what is your subject? You can say whatever. So I can say in here, and say automated reply. So people know somebody's not looking at this and just like, what? We received your email. Or email confirmation. It can be whatever. All right. Now, in your content, this is going to be the body of your email that goes back. And you can use these tags to make it personal. So you can grab the person's name and put it in there and all this other fun stuff. But let's go ahead and just leverage some other tools that we have here. Since we're doing all this AI stuff, let's go ahead and use ChatGPT. I'm going to come over here and just say, create an automated email response to anyone that emails info@ajholmes.com telling them thank you, we received your email and someone will get back to you in 48 to 72 hours. And now again, this is for YouTube stuff. And all, what am I looking for? What's the word I'm looking for? All emails for sponsorships outside of media ministry will be ignored and your email will be blocked. Something like that, all right? And then also, I want it to be, please put this in HTML format. Hit a response. Now, it generated all of this for me. And let's read it through. And actually, let me just copy this and we'll just open this in a web page so you can actually see what it looks like. So we'll paste this in here. And let's save this for our desktop as a test.html. All right, we save that. So now if we open that up, what does that email look like? And now you can add all the formatting and stuff like that if you want to. And it renamed, I think I fat fingered something when I was typing the name of this file. But all right, so this is what the email shows up. Thank you for reaching out. We received your email and someone from our team will get back to you within 48 to 72 hours. Please note, all sponsorship requests unrelated to media ministry will be ignored and your email will be permanently blocked from our system. We appreciate your understanding and thank you for connecting with us, the AJ Holmes team. So I'm going to change that. I don't want the AJ Holmes team. I do like the ring of that, but we're going to make just a slight little change to that. So we come up in here, best regards, and we're going to change this to AJ, the CEO. AJ, the CEO team. All right. So we got everything here. So we're just going to copy this whole text and we're going to make, if we wanted to be fancy, like I said, we could use some of these tags in here to add the person's name. But again, we don't need to do that. So I'm just going to paste that in there. Boom. We got our message. That's what's going to go out. And I have no idea why this keeps not let me use the scroll. But anyway, we save that and that's it. So in this scenario, our stuff is done. So again, we're going to be looking at emails that are coming to info@ajholmes.com and that's it. And let's go ahead and save it. And how often do you want this to run? I want this to run every 15 minutes. You can change this more. You can say run it once, run it every day, or on demand is where somebody has to come in here and physically do it. So I'll just do this maybe every 15 minutes. I don't get that many emails like that, but this is just going to be an example. So we'll have it for 15 minutes, but we're going to analyze it and run it ourselves. All right, so we have this as our test. Let's go ahead and test this whole thing out. So let me go to an email account that I have not used in years. All right, so we got our Hotmail in here. Let's go ahead and send an email. We're going to send it to info@ajholmes.com. Thank you for the awesome video. Thank you again. And this is a test. All right. So we're going to go ahead and send that off there. So now we're going to fire this off manually. We're going to go ahead and run this. And boom, it got a response. And let's just make sure we did everything right. If it didn't go through, this will probably show an error. So we got a test. So if we come in here, all right, see, it said it didn't return any data. So something is not right. So let's make sure that that email didn't get caught in my spam first. And it looks like it did. So an email did not come through at all. So I need to go ahead and turn off. See, I get a bunch of emails here and my quarantine email stuff is too strict. So that's why I'm trying to turn this off, but still filter a lot of this stuff so I can get this stuff working. So give me 1 second to verify and turn off my quarantine stuff for my email. But anyway, the email came through. So there's our email that came through. So now let's see about running this again to make sure that this came through. So let's run it one more again. And boom, there it goes. So see, it grabbed the email and then it responded. So now let's look at our response that came through. All right, we come over here. There's our automated response that came through. And boom, here's the exact format that came through. So every email that comes through that is being sent and captured the way that you want it to, that's the response that's going to go back. So really like that. You could always come in here and format this a little bit more and things like that. So there's our subject. It obviously came back to me because that's where I sent it from. And there you go, using a very simple tool with make.com. So what would be the purpose of this? So just think about it. If you have a prayer list email that somebody's not monitoring all the time, it doesn't, you know, may look at it like once every other day or something like that. You really should be looking at it more if you set up something like that. But just like my email, you want to have a quick response within 15 minutes. So when somebody sends an email so that you can respond back and they said, oh, okay, I got it. They did receive it because here's my response to getting it back. You know, and you can be way more detailed with this. And that's why we're going to play around with AI to analyze and do some more stuff. Because you got to think, you could take this email, have it summarize the content of the email, send it off. You know, you can do this weekly or whatever. It's so much stuff that you can play around with it. But I want to just dip our toe in there with something simple, which is just an automated response, just so that when somebody emails me or you or anybody like that, they'll get a response back and you can format it anyway. But like I said, I can see this being used for a response for a prayer list. You can put up an email in your live stream that people can respond to. If you have questions, you got Bible study and you want to send people that want to join on Zoom or something like that, and you don't want to put your information out. Let me rephrase that you shouldn't put your information out so that anybody could join. You want to have some type of filter. You can have it put in a special request. You intelligently look at it, analyze it, and add them to a list. There's so much stuff that you can do, but this kind of solves the problem with I get emails and I say I don't respond with 48 to 72 hours. At least you're getting a response. And then you can actually maybe run this at the end of the week or every 3 days for me, like the 72 hours, and say, hey, give me a summary of all the emails. So as a reminder I'm dipping and going into all this other stuff. But hopefully it gives you some ideas. If you got some other ideas, that you want me to test out and play around and show you how to do, leave them down below. Or if you're using something like this, put a comment down below and give some other ministries some ideas of how you use this. Again, AI is a tool that can be used for good or bad, but why not use it to help streamline your ministry, your media ministry, or the ministry in general? So that way, if somebody's sending an email, at least they're getting a quick response that somebody is going to respond to it, and you can summarize it. You can do so much stuff with this. But anyway, I think that's about it. I can talk all day on this, but we want to make this one simple. So if you like this type of content, appreciate a like, consider subscribing, hit that bell. That way you get notified when we come out with other videos. And if you have any questions, you can email me at questions@ajholmes.com and you will get an automated response, because that's kind of what we just made. But give me 48 to 72 hours to get a real response from me or anybody on the AJ the CEO team. Anyway, folks, this is AJ. Catch you on the next video. Later.